You've probably heard me talk about Gödel's theorem in the past, and Gödel's theorem actually shows the limitations of almost every theory of reality. So this morning I went again to AI to say, help me create an argument that no theory of reality, no unified theory of reality can be complete. And here's the answer. Here's an argument for why no theory of reality can be complete. I asked actually in the prompt to also explain Gödel's theorem, G-O-D-E-L apostrophe S. Gödel was a mathematician, German mathematician, and a favorite colleague of Einstein. So here's the answer. In 1931, the mathematician Kurt Gödel, or Gödel, proved that any sufficiently complex formal system like a theory of reality must be either incomplete or inconsistent. Any theory is either incomplete or inconsistent. Okay, there are two different things. Incomplete, inconsistent means full of contradictions. Number one, if the system is consistent, it cannot prove every true statement about the system. There will always be true statements that cannot be derived from the axioms of the system. So, in Gödel's argument, there's always a mathematical premise that cannot be supported by the previous mathematic premises. In other words, there's a disruption in the algorithm of reasoning. So, once again, if the system is consistent, it cannot prove every statement about the system. There will always be true statements that cannot be derived from the axioms of the system. By the way, if you want a good example of this, watch the film The Man Who Knew Infinity. It's an amazing film about Ramanujan, the Indian mathematician. Okay, number two, if the system is complete, if the system is complete, it must be inconsistent and contain contradictions. So no complete system exists without contradictions and therefore inconsistency. So in order for a theory to be of reality to be consistent and free of contradictions, it must be incomplete and unable to prove or describe every true fact about reality. Gödel showed that no formal system can be both complete and consistent. Limits of formal systems. Formal systems, like theories of reality, are limited in what they can express and prove. They rely on a fixed set of axioms, rules of inference, and a specific language. But reality itself is not constrained by such formal limitations. Reality is richer, more complex, and more expansive than any formal system we can construct to model it. So no model of reality reflects complete reality. There will always be aspects of reality that cannot be fully captured or proven within the confines of a formal theory. Unprovable truths. Gödel's theorems implied that even if we had a perfect theory of reality, there would still be true statements about reality that cannot be proven from the axioms of the theory. There will always be unprovable truths that lie outside the scope of the theory. This suggests that no matter how complete or unified a theory of reality may seem, there will always be gaps, limitations, and truths that transcend the theory. A truly complete theory of everything is likely impossible. In summary, Gödel's incompleteness theorems, the inherent limitations of formal systems, and the existence of unprovable truths all point to the same conclusion. No theory of reality, no matter how elegant or complete, can be no theory of reality, no matter how elegant or comprehensive can be complete. There will always be aspects of reality that lie beyond the scope of any formal theory. A truly unified theory of everything is likely and unattainable ideal. Okay. Then I asked what are the various theories currently about reality, and gave me a list: materialism, physicalism, idealism, dualism, monism, many worlds, panpsychism. As you know, my favorite is consciousness only monism. If we adopt that, then we accept that all models are incomplete other than consciousness as a field of infinite possibilities that cannot be modeled but can be experienced through transcendence. Let me know what you think.